Hi guys, welcome back again to the channel. So before we go anywhere, I think it's only right that we celebrate a little bit for hitting 100 subscribers on the channel. So let's do that. Woo! Thank you very much, guys. And that is going to be a bugger to clean up, so I'll clean that up and then I'll see you guys in the next bit. As always as well, guys, if you aren't in the Discord, feel free to do so with the link in the description. And my Instagram will also be in the description as well. This is what both of them will look like. And if you are new to the channel here, don't forget to subscribe down below. We're on 108 subscribers at the minute, which is an increase of quite a bit since the last time I uploaded. As you guys can see, we did hit 100 subscribers and now we're on 108. So this video here is going to be broken down into four different parts again. The first part being the performance of the portfolio this week in terms of the negatives and the positives of that. The second part being what has performed and what hasn't performed this week. The third part being what I've actually bought this week, and the fourth part being what I might actually consider buying this week as well. So yeah, let's get into the first part. You guys can see on screen at the minute, we've basically changed across the allocations of money I had from the invest account, and I've split that in half and basically put some of that into the ISA function. So on screen at the minute, you can see inside of the ISA function I have £1,353.63 in terms of how much it's worth, and I have £1,488.61 in terms of what I have invested. Now as you can see in terms of return, we're down 9.23% on that, which is around about £137 give or take. Now if we jump back over to the invest function, you can see as well that inside there, I have £1,041 in terms of actual value and £1,261.86 invested in there as well, which kind of equates to -£220, which equates to about £17.50. So over the last week, I did obviously allocate the money from the invest account and I changed some of that over into the actual ISA account as well. And the reason I did that is because you don't pay any tax and you're allowed a massive amount of allocation into that every year. I believe it's about 20,000. So that way it works a bit better. You don't get any tax on your income. But as you can see on the actual invest here, we did decline quite a bit, but it has just got worse and worse as the week has gone on. However, at the start of this week so far, we are out £20 compared to last week. So we'll see how we get on this week in regards to that. And in the ISA function as well, we'll jump back over there. You can see that basically I'm down £137 there. And overall, we're just kind of getting back out of that negative a little bit as well, just coming into the start of the week there. So that is kind of how we've performed this week. We are down round about, give or take, £300-£400. So yeah, that's how the performance of that has been. So just coming into the second part here, as you guys can see on screen, these are the stocks I have inside my invest account at the minute. So a lot of them have been tanking quite a bit. Like it says, the tech stocks have been sliding quite a bit this week. And if you want to know the reason for that, have a look at this video on screen at the minute. I broke that down thoroughly and basically explained why I'm not too concerned, despite the fact that I am heavily negative. So Ehang, they dropped by quite a bit as well this week, and HCMC, we're still waiting on the results of that lawsuit, so we're still waiting on that. And as you can see, guys, it's not looking too good in regards to that. A lot of it is negative, and Ehang and HCMC, them two alone, have dipped massively, and I'm down nearly £300 combined between them two. So that is what's happened in there. Now if we jump over to the ISA account, you can see at the minute the pies are doing not too bad. The dividends one is alright. The Bitcoin one, I'm not concerned about one bit. That is fine. I'm not even bothered about what that says. That is a long-term hold for me. I plan on holding that for quite a long period of time, just because I believe in the future of Bitcoin, and these stocks there, they do follow that of Bitcoin as well. So if you're a bit curious to why I've kind of went for that pie, I'll also link a video on screen for you to go watch as well in regards to that. So just looking into the actual investments, a lot of these ones here do consist obviously of what is inside the pies as well. You can see Argo Blockchain, I've got 72 shares of that in the ISA one. And also as we go further down, you can see I've got Cellular Goods at 1,000 shares. So that one there as well. And if we keep going down even further, let's get into the big ones because a lot of these small ones are the pies. You can see I've got a couple more shares in Mara there. And Palantir, I bought that, which I'll come into in a little bit. Anything else in there? No, that looks like it's about it. We've got obviously the S&P 500, just 1.5 shares in that. It's better just to get involved with that than not be. So that is kind of what's happened so far with performance this week. Obviously, nothing is doing too well. Obviously, that is kind of how the portfolio is looking. Also as well, if you go down to this bit here, you can see my biggest trade that I do have is Argo Blockchain. And then the ISA account as well, I also have Argo Blockchain as my biggest investment, as you guys can see on screen just now. And so if you want to see a video to why that is, smash the like button. Let's see if we can get to about 8 likes on this video, and then I will do a video explaining why I have Argo Blockchain as my biggest investment. So we'll get into the third part just now, basically explaining why I did buy some of the stocks I bought. So first of all, we'll go into Cellular Goods, which was the first one, as you guys can see here. So that one there, I did buy that. I did a full video breakdown on that, and I do believe it's something I'm going to be holding for the long term. It has dipped massively this week, but like I say, a lot of the stocks have done so as well. And a lot of people have been saying it's not an amazing investment. However, I do believe otherwise, and to be honest, even if it isn't a great investment, if I hold this for 5-6 years, which I'm planning on probably doing anyway, I know that's probably going to show some sort of return, so that is why I'm planning on doing that. And plus as well, cannabis face cream that's basically made up with CBD, the Cellular Goods face cream that they have, has been backed by David Beckham. A lot of higher investors would have obviously looked into this company before he even invested any of his money into it. So I'm following foot because of that reason there. If you want to see my full breakdown on that, you can check out this video on screen here. That explains why I've done that. So that's Cellular Goods. So another one I did buy is Palantir. Now basically that stock there, I got in at $25.34. I was kind of aiming about the $25 mark because I think that is an absolute steal for this company. I've not done a video on this yet, I might do in the coming weeks. However, there is a lot of really good videos on Palantir you guys could go and check out anyway. In the meantime, basically a lot of big massive investors have spoke about this stock. Cathy Woods has spoke about it, ARK Invest has actually bought into the stock massively, and I believe it is a company that has a lot of room to go in the coming months, which is why I've jumped on that bandwagon. I do currently have about 6 shares at the minute, and I just kind of want to get involved in that, see how it goes and see what comes of it, so that's kind of why I've bought that. Besides that though guys, I haven't really bought much else. Now obviously on screen you can see I've bought the Pi Functions here. Now I bought the Bitcoin one. I had about, I think it was around about £1,000 that I could have spent in for these Pis. Now I did chip a lot of money to the Bitcoin one because I believe massively in these three companies here. The dividends one is just used for obviously daily dividends, so you could use that to basically get paid a small amount, and that'll compound interest, and I am planning on investing £150 a month into that. I forgot to mention the Bitcoin one, so I did say here and now, it's £200 is how much I'll put into that every month. Now the growth one, that is basically consisting of a lot of technology stocks, which is a great opportunity to buy these just now because they're really cheap, and I am planning on investing £150 a month into that one as well. And finally, the growth stock here is just a small stock that I'll pay £100 a month into just to get involved in some high-end growth stocks too. So that is basically what I've bought this week. There's Palantir, Cellular Goods, and these pies here. Let's actually get into the final part. Basically, what we're saying here is, at the minute, I am kind of looking to buy Neo stock. Now, that is what my big investment is going to be this week. And what I'm planning on doing is, I'm actually planning on selling some of my Argo shares. Because as you can see at the minute, it is up 156%. And I do have that other Pi on my ISA account, which means that I could dollar cost average into even more Argo in the future. So I'm not too bored about that. That initial investment of, I believe it's £95 I paid for. Let me just quickly check. £95 I paid for. That has done its job, and that is why I'd consider selling some of the Argo this week. As much as I don't want to, I want to have as many shares of that as I possibly can. I do believe that jumping into some Neo as well would be beneficial to the portfolio. Lamb Research, I'm planning on cutting down just a wee bit of that, and also Mara too. So I'm going to cut back some of my profits in order to actually buy some more Neo, because at the minute Neo is $38 a share, which is an absolute steal. So yeah, like I said, I don't have infinite amounts of capital, so that's what I'm planning on doing. I'm planning down on just cutting some of these stocks here and buying some Neo. That's what the plan is for this week. So guys, that is going to be it for this video here. Now, to be honest guys, I don't want to go too deep into why I've bought all of these stocks or whatever. If you want to see why I bought most of them, check out my previous video. I am going to be doing a few videos on these in the coming days, potentially as well. So I don't want to go too deep into why I physically bought all these stocks. Now also as well guys, I am not a financial advisor. Do all your own research first. This is just what I own. Don't just look at these because I own them and just buy them anyway. Like I said as well, with this, in regards to the Neo stock, that is going to actually turn a lot of my portfolio red. And I know that because the only three things that are green at the minute, I plan on cutting them down and taking some profits in order to actually make the full portfolio red, which in turn I believe will turn even more green in the future. So that is the reason for what I'm doing this week. So yeah, that is what's basically been happening with the portfolio. Where about upon taking it, and yeah, guys, if you did enjoy the video, don't forget to subscribe down below, and I will see you in the next one.